Well, hi there, folks. Old Doc Scott here with you, and I want you to stick around because we're going to have a lot of fun today. A little bit later on down in the show, we're going to open the phones out across the country and let them call Old Doc on the air here, and you'll hear yourself right on the teletube right there, and you can call in, try to stump me with an old-time remedy that I might not happen to know, that it's not in my remedy book. My remedy book is in its 15th printing, and I'm going to update it, and who knows, you might send me a remedy that I might just put in my next printing of my book, my 16th printing that will be. That means I've sold many thousands of these things. One reason? Well, that's about the only way that the folks had to go about the doctrine, you know. The most important guy in town, like about a century ago, was the guy that had the black buggy and the great big beautiful horse and his little black satchel. He was the doctor that done the house calls, go out into the countryside, you know, when somebody was sick, if they had pneumonia or flu or whatever, he would go out, and their doctrine was done very, very simple. They didn't have all this modern penicillin and all this stuff. Only thing they had was basically was herbs, roots, barks, and berries, and something that had been handed down from generation to generation. You take figs, for instance, you know, it's mentioned in the Bible several places, and herbs are. That's back in the biblical days, way back, you know, a couple thousand years ago. Seems like them old folks, they had to doctor with a little this, that, and the other. If they had too much constipation, they'd eat turnip greens or something of that sort, and then they'd go to the restroom, I mean really go, the next morning. And these little simple things worked for these people way back. The Indians were just about ahead of everybody, though. You see, way back 2,000 years ago is when it all started in China, of all places, in China. It's when herbal medicine started. Then around the turn of a century there in England, there was a type of medicine show where there'd be an organ grinder with a monkey to create attention around the marketplace. And then they would buy the red peppers and all the different herbs that they would have and the barks and berries that would be brought in from the countryside. And they doctored themselves pretty much. Then when the settlers came to the United States and Canada, they found the Indians. They had the Indian medicine men, and they doctored just from old-time remedies. And some old granny woman in the neighborhood, she would put down all the things that had been handed down to her, very crude, with a pencil, you know, and that was, oh, she'd guard that with her life, you know. So when the kids got sick, it would be an onion poultice for, like, if they had the croup so bad they couldn't hardly breathe, you know, or pneumonia. What would they do? You couldn't get penicillin to go to these fancy hospitals back then. They had to do something. So it was a crude thing. But the way they'd make an onion poultice, a lot of you younger folks don't even know what I mean when I say poultice. That's what they'd take cornmeal, and they'd heat that cornmeal real hot, almost where it would blister you. And then they'd heat the onions. They'd cook, fry the onions, cut them up, fry them up, and make a mush like, mix that with the cornmeal, and then they'd put that on a thin white cloth, and it had the cloth on both sides, kind of a pouch like, and they'd put that on the chest, cover them up real good, let them sleep overnight with that. Next morning they'd get up and spit that phlegm up, and doggone it, it worked. You see, the great medicine man in the sky put these herbs, roots, barks, and berries here for a purpose. And I believe in this. I think on this earth there is an herb, root, bark, or berry that will cure every disease there is if we just knew how to get the right berry to mix with the right herb or whatever, and if we knew how to use it. It's out there. The rainforest, I'm going to say 75% of all the medicine that's made on the face of this earth, if it wasn't for the rainforest, we'd lose it. 75% of it comes from there. That's something to think about, too. All this stuff is made from herbs, roots, barks, and berries. And that's where I come in, you see. Then I have my medicine show, and I'm 80 years old, soon be 80 years old. I've never had another job in my life. It's been handed down to me by old Doc Chamberlain. And the liniment that he had was one called snake oil. Now, you're going to say, snake oil? Yeah, I remember that. My granddaddy used to use that stuff years ago, and I didn't think there's no snake oil left on earth. I've been selling snake oil all these years. I won't let these high-powered nature food stores and all that, they charge you too much money. But we've kept the price of the snake oil down. And here's a bottle. I just happen to have a bottle of it here. That's what it looks like there, a great big bottle of it. And what it is, it's camphor and it's green soap and it's menthol, pine tar soap, all of wintergreen, menthol and benzocaine. Wormwood, it comes from Africa, from way over there. We import sassafras and isopropyl alcohol to make it penetrate. Now the pan of your hand, your body has got oil in the skin, you see. And if you mixed all these, brewed these, mixed them up, put a spoonful of it in your hand, it would not penetrate. So that 100% corn alcohol, isopropyl alcohol, mixed with these herbs, you can put a spoonful in the pan of your hand, and 1 minute later, it'll come through on the other side. And that's the way it gets in there. If you got that old rheumatism in them fingers to where they won't hardly work, and you can't hardly write to old doc, and whatever, or the knees is stiff and won't hardly work, or that back is hurting you at night, and you can't bend over. You see these poor old guys going around here, 45, 50 years old, and they can't hardly walk? I'm almost 80 years old, and I can outrun a scared haint right now. I use that snake oil. That's one of the reason. But the stuff really works, and it's been handed down old Indian formula. A little bit later on, I'm going to tell you how to get you a bottle of that snake oil that you thought there was no more of. And I'm going to tell you where to write me, and I will send it to you. And talking about these old-time remedies, there was one, just plain old turpentine and lard. You'll find that in my remedy book. Now, my remedy book here is in its 15th printing. That means we've sold thousands of these things for in 15th printing. And I'm going to put some new ones in it. The ones that are in here, people love them. It goes back to George Washington's time. Incidentally, George Washington paid $15 to one of his farm people that worked out on the farm there for something for hydrophobia. Mad Dog bit one of his guys, and he's afraid he's going to die. And this guy was handed down, and he paid for that. That's in the archives in Washington, D.C. And the things go back like that, back to George Washington's time. And I'm going to give you one of these books for free a little later, and I'm going to tell you, I want you to get your pencil and paper ready so you won't miss out on it now. And I'll tell you how that you can write to me, and I'll send you one of them remedy books, and you'll cherish it. Give it to some older person for a birthday present or something of this sort, and they'll cherish the thing. Takes about an hour and a half to read all these things in there. Turpentine lard for the sore throat. And you take a turpentine course. Now, it's got not turpentine like you put in paint. It's got to be the medical turpentine. And that comes from the Georgia pine. See, old Doc here, I'm from Toccoa, Georgia is where I'm from, down in the turpentine country, not far from the Indian reservation, Cherokee Indian, that is. And they're the ones that gave old Doc Chamberlain 104 years ago, the Cherokee Indian, that's where he got this formula right here. And I joined his medicine show 60 years ago, and he gave me the formula to the snake oil here. And I'm going to tell you how to get a bottle of that snake oil a little bit later. And I'm going to tell you also, we're going to get on the phone here, and I want the people from across the country, every place, to call old Doc, and you try to stump me with an old-time remedy that I ain't got up here in my noggin, or that ain't in my book here. And I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll send you the remedy book for absolutely free, and I'll throw in a picture of me with a story of my whole life and everything on the back of this thing here. And I write a few songs, you know, here and there, play the guitar a little, got to entertain the people to draw the crowd down, you see. But we're going to have a little fun now out there, all of you that are listening. Now you start thinking, and you're going to say, well, Grandma had one there, like one to make the measles break out, for instance. That's in here. And a lot of folks are going to laugh about this, but it actually was used, and I want you to come to my rescue after I tell you. Back, it used to be the thing that they really feared was when somebody, a small kid especially, came down with the measles and they wouldn't break out just right. They said that's the worst thing when the measles fell on you. It was the awfulest thing that could happen to you almost. Now, in order to make the measles break out, listen close now. Some of you is going to laugh, but this is true, and it's in my book. What they would do, they would go out and get red oak bark and boil it and get that red oak juice out of red oak tree bark. And they'd take sheep dung, sheep manure now. It's, you know, rabbits have the little balls and the sheep balls are a little bigger. They'd get the sheep manure and boil it and strain it like iced tea, mix it 50-50, the sheep manure and the red oak bark, and have the kids to drink it hot. And in about 24 hours, them measles would break out. You'd look like a strawberry. It actually worked. Now, some of you come to my rescue. Call old Doc and say, yeah, my granddaddy used to do that, or my grandmother. And they was the one in the community. Usually there's one or two of them in the small communities that had all these things. But I'll tell you what. Now, I'll tell you right now what I'm going to do. I'm going to send you a bottle of my snake oil. And we have to, the government makes us pack it. Special because it is real medicine. And incidentally, we are registered with the Pure Food and Drug Act, just like penicillin or any of the modern drugs. This is not a make-believe. It is real medicine. These herbs are mixed up together and they're put in a glass bottle like it was done in the old days. We try to stay right with it the way it was. And I'm going to send it. It costs over $3 now since the postage has gone up. I'm going to pay the postage over $3, and then I'm going to send you a bottle of the snake oil. And just for sending and trying it, I'm going to give you my remedy book for free. I'm going to send that in this first package there and my picture. The whole thing, the whole shooting match is going to come to you for the round figure of $15, including, that's all you pay, $15. Now you stay tuned and get yourself a pencil and paper, and I'm going to come back to you in just a little bit and give you exactly where you're going to be able to order your bottle of snake oil with this guarantee. You take the snake oil, and if you have got arthritis or rheumatism or just plain tired, sore, aching muscles, if you play football and you're bruised up all over, try this snake oil. And if it don't do everything that I said it would do, then I want you to send me that empty bottle back, and I'll give you $15 back and let you keep the remedy book and all the other goodies that I'm giving you free just to try. A little bit later now, we're going to give you that address how to send in and order a bottle of genuine snake oil on that money-back guarantee. Hats off to the monkey looking for an ad about a product with worldwide fame. He found it, Snake oil is the name. It's menthol, green soap, camphor, herbs and benzocaine for tired, sore, aching muscles, cramps, cuts, and sprains. Now, if arthritis and rheumatism is driving you insane, try Doc Scott's S-Oil Rub-On Liniment and ease those nagging pains. Buy the first bottle of snake oil, get two gifts for free. My old-time American remedy book and the color picture of me. Sold on a money-back guarantee. Rub it on, rub it on, and keep on a-smiling. I want you to do. Now remember, I want you, if you've got tired, sore, aching muscles, or rheumatism, or arthritis, spend a lot of money, I want you to try my snake oil. If you just happen to be peeling potatoes and cut your finger a little bit, grab the snake oil and put it on there. The oil, the cleaning department in that bottle of snake oil there is the green soap that a surgeon uses to wash his hands before he starts to do surgery. It'll clean it, and it will tone down the pain in about 3 or 4 minutes and tone it right down, and it'll put a plastic-like seal over it to where no more germs can get in there. And Mother Nature, it's no miracle thing. Mother Nature goes to work and heals it. And if you don't use the snake oil to put the artificial scab on it, then Mother Nature will put what we call a scab, and that's to keep the germs out. It really works. And here it is. There's your bottle of snake oil. I want to send you a bottle of snake oil and the remedy book just for listening to me and watching here today, and also my picture here, so you can put that up in the garden to keep the crows from in fact, you put that up in there and the crows will bring back corn they stole 2 years ago. We have a lot of fun with it, and it tells about my medicine show on the back, and many of you have seen me out across the country in person because I have been doing it for over 60 years. I've played over 19,000 performances, and I have shook many hands right out there that's watching me now. You kind of lost me now. Here I am on this modern television, riding that satellite around the earth, and here I am talking about snake oil. Right now, here is just exactly what you need to do to get your package of snake oil and all the goodies that goes with it. Send me $15, just $15, and I'll send you the bottle of snake oil. I'll give you the remedy book and my picture, and I will pay the postage. The postage and the packing and mailing cost over $3. All I want is $15 on a money-back guarantee that if you use my snake oil and it don't do everything that I've told you that it will do here, then you send me that empty bottle back, and I'll send you your money back and let you keep the remedy book and so on. But here's the trick to it. Once you've tried it, This is what keeps Old Doc going. We're going to tell you how to reorder, and you will not be out of snake oil anymore. 8 out of 10 people continue to order it after they find out and get the address as to where it comes from and so on, and they'll give it to their neighbors, and that's where Old Doc makes the little money that he makes. And we have a special on it after you've tried the first bottle. Here's how to send and get yours. Send $15 to Doc Scott. That's D-O-C, Doc, S-C-O-T-T, Doc Scott. And here's the announcer to tell you exactly where to send that $15. And I'll be back in a little bit with more of Doc Scott and the Medicine Show. Thank you. Hats off to the monkey looking for an ad about a product with worldwide fame. He found it, Snake oil is the name. It's menthol, green soap, camphor, herbs and benzocaine for tired, sore, aching muscles, cramps, cuts, and sprains. Now, if arthritis and rheumatism is driving you insane, try Doc Scott's S-Oil Rub-On Liniment and ease those nagging pains. Buy the first bottle of snake oil, get 2 gifts for free. My old-time American remedy book and a color picture of me. Sold on a money-back guarantee. Rub it on, and keep on a-smiling. Doc Scott here again, and I'd just like to take a moment of your time right now. Many of you have got your pencil and paper ready, because I warned you about that, to get the free gift of my old-time remedy book. I want you to send in for a bottle of my snake oil. And remember that the ingredients are camphor, green soap, menthol, pine tar soap, all of wintergreen, menthol, benzocaine, all of wormwood, sassafras, and isopropyl alcohol. And the most important ingredient of all is, while you're rubbing it on those tired, sore, aching muscles, or arthritis and rheumatism, say a little prayer in your own way. And you will be surprised the power that these herbs, roots, barks, and berries, along with that little prayer. I'm not a preacher, and I'm not out here trying to push religion on you, or to do any of this kind of a thing, or ask for donations or anything. I am selling a bottle of snake oil for that's the name of the stuff, snake oil. No snake in it, never has been. $15 to Doc Scott, D-O-C, Doc, S-C-O-T-T. Doc Scott, you send for your bottle of snake oil. I'm going to pack it and mail it, and all I want is $15. I'm going to give the book, the remedy book, my picture, and the whole bit, so you can try it. And you'll be one of the thousands that will reorder, and you'll say, I'll never do without my snake oil. It's just that good. And I think that if you have spent a lot of money on arthritis, we are not kicking doctors. We got to have them. If that cut on your finger is too big, you need to go to the doctor or the hospital to have it sewed up. But if it's a minor cut or scrape or a bruise, use the snake oil, and it's no miracle medicine. It just does, just cleans it, tones down the pain, and it'll last from 8 to 16 hours overnight so you can sleep. A very little amount of money to spend for a good night's sleep, and you will be one that reorders. Here's the announcer to tell you how to get your bottle of snake oil and all the goodies with it, sold on a money-back guarantee. I've enjoyed being with you here on the satellite, riding around the country, and I'm going to just say, keep a-watching. I'll be popping up on television someplace else, and you send in and get that snake oil, and you're going to rub it on, and keep a-smiling. Hats off to the monkey looking for an ad about a product with worldwide fame. He found it. Snake oil is the name. It's menthol, green soap, camphor, herbs and benzocaine for tired, sore, aching muscles, cramps, cuts, and sprains. Now, if arthritis and rheumatism is driving you insane, try Doc Scott's S-Oil Rub-On Liniment and ease those nagging pains. Buy the first bottle of snake oil, get 2 gifts for free. My old-time American remedy book and a color picture of me. Sold on a money-back guarantee. Rub it on and keep on a-smiling.